Go for Leadership, the podcast with Daniel and Gerd.
How to overcome lack of leadership and accountability. An example of the Ford Motor Company. Hello and welcome to the Go for Leadership show.
Go for Leadership Tools.
I want to share a very great story about Alan Mulally, who was the CEO of the Ford Motor Company. When Alan Mulally met with Bill Ford to consider becoming the CEO of Ford Motor Company, there were a lot of concerns at the beginning. "The operating people are on quicksand," Ford told Mulally. "I need help." Mulally explained how at Boeing his entire leadership team participated in a lightning-fast analysis of the entire business every Thursday morning. Each direct report delivered a brief status update, highlighting anything that had changed since the previous week's meeting. It was the centerpiece of Mulally's management philosophy. He would use it in Dearborn. "This is going to be a culture shock," Ford cautioned. The board's expectation. Bill Ford wanted to make sure Ford's board of directors agreed with the decision to hire Mulally. Two board members, Hockaday and Thornton, met Mulally for lunch. They quickly went from skepsis to salesman. They had only one concern. "Alan, if the board offers you this job and you take it, you need to understand that there are no sacred cows," Hockaday told Mulally. "Any friends of Bill that are in the wrong position or you conclude are not the right guys, you can get rid of them immediately. And Bill will confirm that." Mulally shook his head. "That's not an issue because I'm not going to have to get rid of many people," Mulally mentioned. So, Mulally's response was worrisome for Hockaday and Thornton. They believed the time had come for bloodletting at the top of the house in Dearborn. The weakness of Ford's bench prompted them to look outside the company for a CEO in the first place. "How do you come to that conclusion?" Hockaday said. Mulally responded by outlining his system of weekly meetings for them, just as he had for Ford. He told them his approach and forced extreme accountability on a weekly basis. It left no hiding place for those not committed to executing their part of the business plan. "It's likely that a lot of people at Ford aren't used to that, and they will self-select out," Mulally said. "I won't have to do it." Now, sticking deeper into the Ford Motor meeting week. Mulally's first week was meeting week at Ford Motor Company. Each month, Ford senior executives sat through one agonizing coaches after another, each devoted to a different issue or facet to the company's operation. There were meetings to discuss Ford finances, meetings to discuss sales, meetings to discuss marketing, meetings to discuss new products. Since Ford executives seemed to like meetings so much, Mulally asked his secretary to schedule one more. When he had them all together, Mulally started laying down his law. "There are too many meetings," he told them. "When do you have time to think about the customer?" Nobody answered. From now on, Mulally continued, there would be only one corporate level meeting, his business plan review, or BPR. It would be held every week on the same day, at the same time, in the same place. Attendance would be mandatory for all senior executives. Each executive would personally deliver concise status reports and updates on their progress towards the company's turnaround goals. This would not be a forum for discussion or debate. Any issue that required more in-depth consideration by the entire leadership team would be taken up in a Special Attention Review Meeting, or SAR meeting, immediately followed by the BPR, the Business Plan Review. The idea was to keep the main meeting focused on the big picture. The data sets you free, he said with a smile. We are the decision makers, Mulally said. We need to make decisions and not pass the buck. Ford executives, unwilling or unable to perform, did self-selected themselves out. The result, Ford made a dramatic turnaround, and Ford Motor Company was the only US car dealer not to get a government bailout. Mulally's BPRs changed Ford's culture, eliminated office politics. More importantly, it created a harmonious culture of accountability. An important part of a leadership is being able to hold two things in your mind at once. Dealing with the reality, whatever it may be, and focus on hope for the future. Any leader helping an organization through challenges needs to be able to do both. A quote by Alan Mulally.
Go for Leadership, the podcast with Daniel and Gerd.
Thanks for listening in and looking forward for the next session of the Go for Leadership show.
Go for Leadership, the podcast with Daniel and Gerd.